if America has a cold, we have cancer. This is Jules calling from Toronto.
Jules, what's going on, man? Welcome to the program.
Thank you, man. Follow you on Twitter. Follow you and Karen on Twitter. Yeah, I've been a long-time follower, first-time caller. Honestly, I'm so confused, and forgive me for this. Like, why are there not bodies, like, riddled over the Capitol of people in their Trump flags and their guerrilla wear? Like, I don't understand why there aren't. And I don't usually wish death on anybody, but I'm confused. I don't understand why there aren't more dead people.
So, thanks for the call. And that's the question. That's where I was getting to. So I'm glad you, goddamn, I'm glad you set it off. I don't understand. So, our nation's capital is under federal property, under direct threat, not implied, not assumed, not presumed, direct threat. And the fact that it hasn't been dealt with in a way according to how these individuals, and I know some of them personally, Capitol Police, Secret Service, and otherwise, who train year round for their entire career for moments like this. I don't understand how the response has not matched the threat. When we saw protesters kneeling over the summer, and I was there personally, and I saw lines and lines of unmarked officers working on pure aggression, ready to draw their weapons. And we see our United States Capitol, the seat of our very democratic government, under attack and maybe one shot fired. So I don't know. I don't have an answer. I don't understand it either.
My concern is, okay, you could start with the horses. I haven't seen horses. I've been watching a little bit of television. I don't see the horses. I don't see the militarized equipment with the water cannon or the thing that they use for the sound.
Yeah, the sonic boom. People, yeah, right. Make people shit their pants. Yeah, on the spot. You shit your pants. Yeah, yeah.
And they own it. And then literally, like, I thought it was a lie because I wanted to kind of research before I really started spreading it. But they literally denied the National Guard request to have the National Guard. It was denied by Trump's people. It was denied. And Virginia sending National Guard people to, after, like, you would think that, you know, it's FBI, all this kind of stuff. You know what's happening. So you're going to be prepared. You're not going to let yourself look stupid, egg on your face. But Trump literally invited people to the Capitol, and now we're in the situation that we're in.
Yes. Yes.
You know what I mean? So that's
now you're calling from Toronto. So you're Canadian, correct?
I'm 100% Canadian.
What I was going to ask, so as a Canadian resident, as a neighbor, what does this look like to you? Like, how is it viewed in another country? How is this viewed?
Well, think about it like this. If America has a cold, we have cancer, basically, right? So if things are going crazy in the U.S., we're extremely concerned because it affects a lot of our financial stuff. We're really messed up because of that. You're a major trade partner for us. And a lot of us have family down there, and we can't really discuss our politics. We can't discuss our economy without discussing American economy. Trump has really made us lose jobs, lose opportunity for the time that he's been in power. And he's screwed some things up for generations now because of the decisions he's made. And it just makes us all nervous because we all have family, especially in Florida, Arizona. We have people that are down there because they're snowbirds, that's what we call them. They go down there and they live there. And people are concerned for them.
Mm. Yeah. Right? I appreciate the call, man. Thanks for calling in.
Thanks, man.
Peace.